Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we're gonna take a look at a tool called MathPix Snip, and we're gonna look at how it works at screen grabbing math problems and reinserting them into accessible MathML. The first thing I'm going to do is open up a Microsoft Word document so that I can paste my equations in, and then I'm gonna launch the MathPix Snip OCR tool. There's also a desktop version of this program that I'll probably cover in another video. I'm going to select this option called New Snip, and it's going to allow me to draw a box around the content. And what this does is it performs OCR on the math content. Now, if I select the Data tab, I can come over here and actually copy MathML for Microsoft Word with a click of a button. Before we go any further, please hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. Come into my Microsoft Word document and paste the math. Now I have MathType installed on my computer, so it's asking me if I want to create a MathType equation, which I do. And then it inserts the equation that I copied. And what's awesome about this is MathType inserts the equations with MathML. So this equation is fully accessible for screen readers and other forms of assistive technology. Now, of course, we would want to add our other semantic information, like a heading. We can make that a heading level one. And then let's go ahead and grab another equation. I'm going to launch the MathPix snipping tool, and let's take another equation. All right, I'm going to select the new snip, drag my box around the equation I want, and it automatically copies the equation for me in MathML. And I can come into the Word document and paste it. And there we go. Now we have two sample equations in our Microsoft Word document that are accessible, and I didn't have to rekey them. This would allow me to then take this file and create an accessible web page or leave the Word document as is. Again, the MathPix snipping tool is just one tool in my toolbox for creating accessible math. And in the future, I'll be creating more videos on how to create accessible math. As always, thank you for tuning in, and I'll catch you next time.